friends, welcome to my channel. In this video, I plan to tell India vs Australia Women's T20 World Cup Final. So in my previous video, I have told that Australia have posted a mammoth 183 on the scoreboard. So that means pressure on the India's top order. Both India batsmen Smriti Mandhana and Shefali Verma were on crease. They gave a poor start to India as a 16-year-old Shefali Verma was caught by Megan Skirt of Alexa Healy. New batsman was a wicketkeeper batsman Tanya Bhatia. Unfortunately, she was retired out at the score of 2. India were in deep trouble when Jemina Rodrigues was caught by Nicola Carey by Jess Jonathan. Soon after hitting some glorious boundaries, Smriti Mandhana was caught again by Nicola Carey of Sophie Molnix. Since then, India's skipper Harmanpreet Kaur and Deepthi Sharma have been trying to stitch a partnership but failed, as the skipper was caught by Garner of Jess Jonathan. New batsman was Veda Krishnamurthy. End of the pop, 34 for the loss of 4 wickets in 7 overs, 149 runs to win 76 balls, 39 for the loss of 4 wickets in 8 overs. Now Veda Krishnamurthy had a much needed 4 for India. End of the over, India just could not get the boundaries. The boundaries have been dried up in the last couple of overs. 129 runs to win from 9 overs. After a quite slow 23 runs partnership, Veda Krishnamurthy was caught by Jess Jonathan by Megan Scott. New batsman is Richa Ghosh. Score is 64 for the loss of 5 wickets. Now I will tell you the winning percentage. Australia 99% and India 1%. And now after the match, India have lost a match and India have been bowled out before even they reached the 100 runs mark. India have been bowled out 99 runs in 19.1 overs. So 5-time World Cup champions take a bow to Australia. Australia have lost the first game, nearly lost the second, scrapped through the semis, just about got held by the luck and the rain gods to reach the final. But come at the final, come at the whore, the world champions, the defending champions, the strut they stuff, reserving their best for the last. Well, Australia can celebrate, so can the crowd, but surely the supporters deserve better. Not just the Indian supporters, but a sport fan in general. A big hype final watched by millions around the globe surely deserved to have a better contest. Sadly, there was no contest, only one team was playing. Cricket is all about techniques, your game sense, your footwork, your timing, your skill, etc, etc, etc. It's also about one more thing. The thing is not taught by any coach or any dictionary or in any book. Nerves. You need to get that experience and try it and get it better. Australia winners because this unit was playing its first home World Cup final. India winners as well because they were also playing the first World Cup final. Then Beth Mooney was given a chance in the fourth. That just holds the nerves and emotions India were going through, and Australia pounced. In the batting, if you see Australia's, it was just superb. From the starting, Alexa Healy's brilliant 79 runs supported well by Beth Mooney's 62 runs. Thus reached Australia women to 184 for the loss of 4 wickets. And if you're looking at the bowling after the wicket of Shefali Verma, things just gone wrong for India women. So, yet another women's World Cup T20 over. But 2020 have some more bonus. Just 21 days after, it's going to be the much-awaited tournament, the IPL. And after 5 months on October 2020, it's going to be yet another World T20. This time, it's going to be the men's, which is also in Australia. So thank you for watching my channel. Kindly like, subscribe and comment. Thank you.